Protecting WordPress sites is a big pain in the ass because WordPress is one of the most famous CMS platforms on the planet. That means that if a hacker wants to hack a site, the probabilities of it being a WordPress site are really high. So that's why they focus on WordPress sites. So I'm going to show you how to prevent hackers from hacking your site before they even reach your hosting server, okay? And for this, I am going to use a free version of Cloudflare, which is really popular and easy to use. So once you connect your DNS, we're going to be able to set up the rules to prevent hackers from hacking your WordPress site. So let's get started with this. Okay, so this is one of my sites, and you can see I already have my security enabled on Cloudflare. That means that to reach my site, Cloudflare is taking care of the DNS propagation. So when a hacker tries to hack the site, it first goes through Cloudflare before reaching my hosting provider. That way, there's no server load, there's no hackers on my site or server, and it's a really easy system to implement. Now, before I show you the rules that I want to implement, now before we jump into the setup of the security section of Cloudflare, let me show you our sponsor, which is Hostinger. I have several of my sites in Hostinger, and I do recommend it. To grab a hosting plan, I do recommend that you jump into hosting, and you have two popular options, web hosting and BPS hosting. I'm on BPS, so I'm gonna show you. If you grab a BPS plan from the ones that they have available, for example, this popular one, which is $79.99 a month, I'm gonna select it. And once we select it, we are greeted with two type of plans on the BPS. So we can select 1 month or 12 months. If you select 12 months, you grab the lower price and you grab a lower renewal fee. So it's way better to grab the 12 months. But there's an additional discount that I want to show you. So click on have a coupon. Remember, right now it's $95.88. And if you add my coupon, SaaSmaster, there's an extra discount. So now it's $86.29. So take advantage of that coupon code. Now let's jump over into my Cloudflare setup where I'm gonna show you how to block these hackers. And even if you are on a Hostinger plan, you can still use Cloudflare as your DNS provider. So it's pretty cool, right? So right now I am in the analytics section for security for this particular website. And you can see over the 30 days, it's blocked 4,370 threats in 30 days. And that's low, okay? Why is that low? Because they know my site is protected. So it's less prone to getting hacked. Once you first set up your rules, well, the ones I'm gonna show you, you're gonna have 10,000, 15,000 of these trying to hack your site, okay? So these are my analytics right now for security. You can see everything that's been blocked. And to block these, go over to security, and you're gonna be able to view the events. The events will only show up once you set up your WAF or your bot's protection. So let's go into the WAF, which is the firewall rules. And in the free plan, you get to set up 5 rules, which is more than enough if you know how to set it up, okay? So basically, my rules are focused on a WordPress site, okay? And what I do to block, for example, I am blocking everything that goes to the URL path where I don't want hackers to access. So to set up a rule, go to create a rule, or in this case, I'll jump into this particular rule. And I do recommend that you copy this if you plan to use it the way I am using it, okay? So what I do, the URL path contains wp-admin/, well, it's going to block, okay? This is what it's going to do, block. I can also do a manage challenge. That means that sometimes you jump into a site and it wants to decide if you're a bot or not. And if you're not a bot, you can tick the little tick and you can jump in, okay? But in this case, I am blocking. So I'm doing a hard block on these particular sites. Why? Because it's my login page. It's my XML RPC page. It's the Ajax, admin Ajax. So these are pages that hackers should not have access. Even I am blocking myself, okay? Be aware of that. But to unblock myself, I have to set up a rule in manage rules to add my own IP. You might not want to do that. So maybe the easiest route for you will be manage challenge, at least for the admin section. What happens if you have a particular admin page? If it's not wp-admin, well, all you have to do is add, you could say or and, okay? In this case, it'll be or. And I'll say the URL path, you can say equals contains, and in this case, it's going to contain, maybe it's admin. Maybe that is the page that you want to block, okay? So right now it's been added to the rules. And if I save this, if I try to go to that path, it is going to block it. In this case, I have my IP already white labeled, so it's not going to be blocked. Let me unwhite label it and let me go into my admin page just to show you. Okay, so I'm going to go to my rules tools right here, and I'm going to disallow me. So this is the one I just added right now. I'm going to delete it. Okay, let's go back into my WAF rules. Let's go into the login page of my site. Let's go over there and boom, it's been blocked. I haven't even reached the hosting provider to even try to hack the site. So I've been blocked. Boom, I can't jump in. In order for me as a user to actually access my site, I have to go to the tools and add my IP. Okay, so you need to know what my IP is. If your IP is dynamic, well, that might get a little complex and you'll have to add it every single time you want to access your site. But if you're accessing your site every 2 weeks, every month, well, it's not such a big hassle jumping into Cloudflare and added the rule in the tools, okay? So that is my WordPress blocking system, okay? Now there's more rules that you can add. Remember, you have up to 5. I'm also adding a threat score. So that means that if Cloudflare knows that if someone is already targeted as a threat, well, it's gonna block it. And for this, I've added a value of 40, okay? Greater than 40, it's gonna block that person. Well, it's gonna manage challenge in this case. A managed challenge, remember, it's like if it wants to know if you're a bot or not, and that's how it continues, okay? Next, I am also doing a managed challenge for HTTP version, okay? So let me show you this rule. And remember, this is what I'm using. If the version is 1.0, which is an old version, it'll do a managed challenge also, okay? And you can see here that the CRS, the challenges solve rate is 0%. What does that mean? Well, 20 people with an HTTP version of 1.0 went to my site and didn't even follow through. It didn't go through the challenge of Cloudflare to jump into my site. So that means 0%. So these are fake users, okay? If it was a real user, they would go through the process of saying, you know what, I am a human, and boom, they will jump into my site, okay? And again, there's another one that I've added, which is block suspicious query parameters. This is for a protection inside of WordPress for the plugins. So let me show you this one. Sometimes I turn it off when I do some updates, okay? So this is my rules to block suspicious query parameters inside of the WordPress site for the plugins. So plugins won't be able to access these sections or these type of rules if I have this enabled. So these are the rules that I've added. The most important one that you should add are these, the WordPress rules, okay? Remember, and you decide if you want to do a hard block or if you want to do a managed challenge or use the other systems that they have, okay? So that's blocking my admin page, the login page, another type of login system, the xmlrpc.php page, which they shouldn't have access, and the admin-ajax.php. If you have a particular plugin that has a different type of link that you don't want hackers to access, you can add it right here, okay? So this is the way I block these people. Now, if you go to the events, we're gonna be able to view all the block rules that we've done, okay? So right now, this is me, this is Mexico, it's been blocked. Remember, I've removed my IP, so that means I've been blocked, okay? And if you see, there's India for the custom rules, it's been blocked by default. Why? Because they tried to access my admin section. See that? They have no reason to be there and they've been blocked before even reaching the hosting provider, okay? Another custom rule, someone from Ireland, and they tried to go to the wp-login.php section of my site. So they've been blocked, okay? So this is a really neat way. This is someone from United States and they've been blocked because they try to reach this page. Someone who's surfing around your site has no business jumping into those pages. So automatically they've been blocked. So that's a really great way to block hackers from getting into your site and hacking your site. So do take advantage of Cloudflare. Like I said, this is the free version. So no payment at all. You get access to up to 5 rules. You decide if you want to use 1 or 5. But like you saw right now in the WP rule, I've added several of these rules inside of there. And you can add many more because remember, you can add and or as rules there. So it's a really neat way to use this, okay? You also have access to rate limit rules. So that means that if someone tries to hack your site constantly, for example, you got, I don't know, 1,000 hits in 1 minute, which is impossible, right? A human can't go into the site 1,000 times. So you can create a rule for that and you have access to one in the free version, okay? Like I said, even if you're on the hosting or plan, you can still use Cloudflare and connect it through there. So you can buy your hosting plan over here, connect your propagation DNS through Cloudflare, and do the blocking of the hackers over there. So it's a really neat way to do this, and it's free on the Cloudflare side. So take advantage of that. And don't forget to use the coupon code if you want to grab a plan on Hostinger. Remember, there's an extra discount coupon code that's in the description. And that's a wrap.